Good morning. I am bringing you five books today. Just wanted to kind of, I've been reading a lot the last month and I just kind of wanted to get them all in there in one swift go. The first three I'm going to talk to you about are mysteries. Two are YA mysteries and the other one is just an adult mystery. All three I thought were super amazing. The first one is The Cheerleaders by Kara Thomas. And I also read A Good Girl's Guide to Murder by Holly Jackson. Those two were very similar. I was kind of surprised. I read A Good Girl's Guide to Murder first, and it was really funny. It was about a girl. She's doing her like senior project, and she's trying to prove that one of her friends did not kill like the most popular girl in school 5 years ago. So she sets her thesis out. She lines up everything. She does a lot of interviews. And that leads to a whole bunch of stuff happening. So that one was amazing. I loved it. I highly recommend it. It's a short, fast read. And then I read this one next and very eerily similar. Five cheerleaders die and they just dismantle the whole cheerleading squad and becomes a dance squad, and one of the sisters just can't believe their sister would kill herself, and so she sets out to find what really happened, and of course, you know, everything that could go wrong goes wrong, but she does find out in the end what happened. I will tell you, with A Good Girl's Guide to Murder, there is multiple books, so it's a series. It's a short series. I think there's only three, or there's the third one's coming out, so it's not that long. And then the adult version that I read in the mystery category is Before She Disappeared by Lisa Gardner. She's one of my favorite authors to read in that category. And this is about a lady who, she's an alcoholic and recovering. So she hasn't drank in 20 years. But what she does for like a job is she goes where there's people missing, usually young adults, and she tries to find them or find what happened to them. But she usually ends up working in a bar, kind of living, you know, above the bar, and she wants to find out what happened to these missing people, and she goes all around the country and does this. But along the way, she kind of forms a relationship. Super awesome. If you love Lisa Gardner, which I do, I highly recommend those three mysteries. Just wanted to follow up on, I am still reading some fantasy, although I said I would never read fantasy. I'm actually really enjoying it. I just finished From Blood and Ash by Jennifer Armentrout. Oh my, it is a must read. I'm waiting for the library to release the second one so I can get it. Super, I love it, I love it, I love it. It's about Poppy, who's a maiden in this fantasy world, and she's waiting for the ascension, and in this meantime, that just means she's kind of hidden from everybody. But in the meantime, she meets a new young guard to guard her named Hawk. And he just doesn't seem he's not who he seems to be. But anyway, this is very high fantasy, vampires, werewolves, fae, things like that. But it's super awesome. You got to give it a try. It's very sexy, so just be aware. And then I'm still continuing reading the Outlander series. Oh my gosh. If you have not read it, you have to read it. And I will tell you, the books go along. I'm going to scoot back over. The books go along with the series on Netflix. So book one is season one. I will tell you that the books by far are way better than the series, although you'll enjoy the series on Netflix as well. But The Outlander, I'm on book four, which I believe is The Drums of Autumn. And they actually are now in America. So I don't know if you know anything about The Outlander, but Claire falls through some stones. She ends up in 1745 Scotland. She falls in love. But then he sends her back to 1968, to her former life. And then she ends up spending 20 years in the Boston area before her husband dies. I'm kind of giving you some spoilers. Before her husband dies that she was married to begin with, and then she goes back to Scotland. But they are now shipwrecked in Georgia, and so they're trying to make their way up the east coast of the United States in the late 1700s. So it's kind of, you guys know I love historical fiction. So this book, I told Mitchell, we are going to Scotland next summer. I'm no qualms about it. I'm going to go. I want to do all the tours. I loved Ireland, but I think that Scotland is going to be amazing. Just the stuff that they talk about. The history that Diana puts into her books is amazing. I mean, plus just the fantasy aspect of going back in time, would you do it? But there's some amazing characters. So if you have not read the Outlander series, highly, highly recommend it. And if you don't want to read, just watch the series. You might enjoy Scotland. But anyway, those are my five books. I will bring you more next month. I hope you enjoy at least one of them. Let me know. Give me a shout out. Bye.